the region of Apulia is 800 miles of coastline, adorned with the beautiful, of course, on the Adriatic side. And it's the number one food producer of all of Italy for wine. It boasts 500 million ancient olive trees. And of course, what's indigenous to the Apulia region is what we're showcasing, the orecchietti pasta, which means the little ears, the cavatelli pasta, the seafood, the tarali, which is the baked biscuits. All these things are really traditional. The panzerotti, all these things that we have done at this beautiful event in East Vancouver. And of course, it's known as the number one producer in all of Italy for olive oil. It's the highest ranking olive oil top in the world. And of course, the vineyards. My father, which was born and raised in Bari Carbonare, would tell you about the wine. It's just because of the warm weather. And even now, you know, in May, it starts to get in the 20s, quite warm, and it starts to go until October when they harvest.
We have many variety of grapes. We have, I think, export the most one in Italy. The what they call table grapes, and then we also do the red wine for wine, but very, very big place for a variety of grapes. Provincia of Bari, they call the big city, which is almost the capital of the Puglia. And when I was born in Carbonara, I think it's the second biggest, and in all the other regions, another smaller town. But there's quite a few altogether.
But definitely the coastline, the 800 miles with the Lecce, Foggia, Brindisi, Bari, it's the largest in of all of Italy, with most of the big cities. And again, they do have the largest producers, again, of the food and the wine. Of course, we talk about Italy, but the history, the culture of Bari, and that Nicola di Bari, we call it.
Nicola di Bari is a saint that has been 1,000 years and maybe more. So, and it's a beautiful city. It's a nice place to visit.
And I must say, it's well known that the region of Apulia is known to have the nicest people in all of Italy. So the warm, so when people come to travel, it's very sincere people that are very passionate, that want to bring you and explain the culture, the people, the food, the wine, the history. So they're known as the nicest and warmest people of all of Italy. Of course, the Italians are wonderful people, but this is their claim to fame. It's been tremendous. We've had a lot of followers here. As you can tell, we've had pre-booked seating here of 20, and I think we've jammed this booth in double or 2.5 times that. People are really interested in trying to find out the culture and diversity and what's indigenous to the region of Apulia. So it's been a tremendous experience for us. We've been honored to be able to deal with the people and show the people and educate the people on this. So it's been overwhelming, really. I never expected the whole booth to be really into it. And really, when we do these, we say we're in Little Italy, we're doing a little passionate Little Italy, and think of the warm weather and the little cafe and the bistros, the espresso, the gelato, and the communication of people bantering, talking back and forth, and just enjoying the life.